Subject, Alexander, Taurus, male, 35 to 40 years old, no known family, active service with 7th Cavalry, presumed deceased, body not recovered, preliminary psych evaluation, post-traumatic stress consistent with period origin, subject, otherwise considered, neurologically sound, moderate to high percentage likelihood of operational fitness. Subject is no longer comatose.
Alexander Morris, you are indeed back among the living. Please come up here so I may tell you about your future in service of history. You are in the future from your perspective. around 300 years or so, if you're curious. We are Chronotech, and through the research and efforts of our founder, Dr. Ranier Cole, we have made time travel not only possible, but practical. It's a recent innovation. Dr. Cole took his first trip 20 years ago, and we are very careful in our travels. We use it only for research. But what a fantastic gift! The mysteries alone we've solved. Chronotech travelers witnessed monoliths being raised at Stonehenge. Another team discovered why the Mayan civilization disappeared. We've discovered and learned so much. But with the power of time travel comes the responsibility of protecting history. Dr. Cole is a fanatic about this. It's one of the reasons we call him the Father of Time. He knew changing history would be dangerous and foolish. Together, the goals of discovery and protecting history form the prime objective of Chronotech. Keeping that in mind, there have been some very disquieting developments. First, Dr. Cole is missing. I fear the very Father of Time is lost somewhere, some time out there. Second, we are identifying certain historical events out of place and certain people being put suddenly in harm's way. We discover new anomalies every day and we can't find the cause or connection. I can explain neither Dr. Cole's absence nor the changes we've been seeing, but I have a strong hunch they're related somehow. That's where you come in, Alexander Morris. You will be sent to different places in their times of great strife and change, charged with saving those people facing an untimely end. You are the perfect candidate to help our cause, and I'm sure you'd like to show your gratitude for being rescued from certain death. There's more you need to know, and you must have some questions. For the answers, step into the portal and meet the man who will help you along in your quests. Agent Dexter.
I guess you're the fucking new guy, huh? Now, you got some work to do, and I think you should start with some weapons training. Things are a bit different these days. We're sending you out with a rifle and a pistol. Depending on when you're headed, you'll be issued the right guns for that time. You can only carry two guns at a time, but you can pick up any gun you might find. See if you can sight in that old boy. Well done. I think you have the right idea. For a quick reload, fire again when it flashes green. If you miss it, your weapon jams up and it takes even longer. You can zoom in a bit with the weapon's sights and get a more accurate shot. Let's see you put that to work. Take out that soldier. Not too bad. But out there, they don't stand still. Hit some moving targets. Keep at this as long as you want, but no matter how many targets you knock down, you ain't winning the big stuff bunny. These are standard issue stick grenades. Just aim and let them fly. Toss a couple out there and see if you can take out old Hanns. Hot damn, just like a big old firecracker. Toss a few more if you like. Old Hanns will keep on coming back. Remember, they can throw them at you too. All right, son. I think you figured out them grenades. We might run across some artillery, so let's get you checked out on the big guns. You can change the cannon's aim from left